Dame Tariana Turia there, one of five Māori leaders behind a Waitangi tribunal claim, alleging the Crown has breached the treaty in its approach to whānau order. Whānau order, a holistic approach of improving outcomes for Māori, was a Māori Party policy in the last government. One of the other leaders behind the claim is Merepeka Raukawa-Tait, Te Arawa Whānau Order Commissioning Agency Chair for the North Island. Beside her is Sir Tā Mark Solomon, Kaitahu and Chair for the agency in the South Island, Te Waipounamu. Tēnā kōrua, welcome to Q&A. Tēnā
kōrua.
Merepeka, I'll begin with you. You met with Jacinda Ardern this week regarding your concerns around the funding for whānau order. Did you get what you wanted?
Well, we were very pleased that the Prime Minister did make time to meet with us, and our discussions were very full and frank. Obviously, when you've got Dame Nader and Dame Tariana in the room, there's nothing but a full and frank discussion. The Prime Minister was concerned with what we had to say to her, was that we feel there has been an undermining of the value of whānau order. And I suspect that she wasn't fully informed about not so much the value, but about what we were concerned about, what we think is at stake if you start to haul whānau order funding back into the mainstream agencies, government agencies, then to us that would be the death knell.
When you say she wasn't informed in that space, what do you mean by that?
Well, we explained clearly about whānau order, and she does know about whānau order, and she knows the value, but I don't believe that she knew the degree of underfunding that we've been experiencing, and also the undermining by her minister, the Minister of Whānau Order, about the value of whānau order.
Pēnei Henare, the minister responsible, has suggested that your letter might have been motivated for political reasons. Mm-hmm. You are a member of the Māori Party.
That's true.
Do politics play a role in this?
I think politics always plays a role in it.
So you sent that letter for political reasons?
No, we sent that letter because we are concerned. We are the leaders in our community. We are the leaders of this program, which is really about a different method of delivering social services to support Māori in their aspirations, and their priorities. And it has been highly successful. So when you've got a minister now that decides that he's going to look at funding and perhaps put it back into government agencies, it's not going to be successful any longer.
So have your concerns been alleviated after that meeting with the Prime Minister?
Not so far, but all we have to say is that the Prime Minister was willing to listen to us, and we made it quite clear that we know what's at stake long term if whānau order gets undermined by the government and by her minister. So we will watch this space.
Tā Mark, your name wasn't on that letter, no. I noticed. Should we read anything into that?
No, not at all. I read about the claim in the media.
Right.
I put a letter out as the chairman of the GPL of Te Pitahitanga in support of the concept, because we genuinely believed also that with the funding, the 80-odd million that had been put across for whānau order, was going to a government agency. And I would point out, so did Tapuni Kokiri.
Do you share Merepeka's concerns regarding the performance of the whānau order minister, Pēnei Henare?
To be honest, I've only met the minister twice on a personal level. I do have concerns around the funding regime. If I take Te Pitahitanga in the south as an example, we have 57 navigators, but we're funded for 16. Now, those navigators are playing a huge role in improving the lot out there amongst our whānau. They are needed, but as I say, we have 57, but we're funded for 16. And we thought, with all the rhetoric about the money coming for whānau order, would boost the delivery.
Merepeka, what will it take for you to withdraw your claim?
Well, it'll take a lot more than just people nodding and saying, yes, you're doing great work. We want to see significant funding coming our way, particularly coming up in this budget. We also expect the Minister of Whānau Order to go out to bat for us and actually to articulate the value of whānau order as opposed to the normal government agency response to providing services. They have never served us well, and the Minister should know that. And if he wants to go off and say, well, we're going to look at hauling back or funding government agencies to provide whānau order services, then he should know what's at stake. And so he needs to step up, actually, and really, because he probably thinks, well, yes, it was a Māori Party initiative from the previous government. Well, so what? If it's been highly successful, then support it. But stop trying to make himself relevant, and because it's not going to work.
Tā Mark, your inquiry into Oranga Tamariki called for a complete overhaul. Is that going to happen?
The evidence is there. The evidence is there in their own review of the happenings at Hawke's Bay. The evidence is there in the Children's Commissioner's report. It's evidence is there in the Ombudsman's report. There are issues of structure of delivery within Oranga Tamariki that need to be addressed. And I participated in some of the programs where we met with those that have been through the system, and they weren't just parents that had their children taken from them. There were grandparents, there were social workers, that they're all raising the same sort of concerns. I mean, to sit in a meeting where a woman makes the statement, it is far better to stay and take the beatings than raise your hand for help, because if you do, you lose your children.
So do you have confidence anything is going to happen?
No. I think if we keep the pressure up, yes, they will change. There's a lot of rhetoric out there, but the actions to date are not matching the rhetoric.
What do you mean by that?
Well, there's lots of talk about relationship with iwi, etc. Let's be real about that. Ngaitahu joined up in a relationship last year, Tūhoe last year, Tainui Waikato the year before. Three iwi out of 59? They don't have big relationships. I grew up in the era in Canterbury under the Matua Whānau. The woman that ran it in Christchurch was a woman, Kui Neho Neho, Kui Sterling. Now, Kui knew all the families. If a family got into trouble, she could immediately have contact with the extended whānau. When Matua Whānau was got rid of and the role taken over by SIPS at the time, they lost all those connections.
Yeah.
Just what we're talking about.
To be clear, though, you don't have faith at the moment that anything is going to change.
Like I say, there's lots of rhetoric, but we haven't seen the actions yet.
Let's consider Labor and the government.
And what I will say, we've now got a process underway where there's a process of setting up an independent complaints process for Oranga Tamariki, potentially through the Ombudsman's office. There's a process of beefing up the Children's Commissioner's role, splitting it in two. One, he still has the role of advocacy, but the other, a Commissioner's role, will be monitoring the performance. He's given one report.
Merepeka, the Māori Party President, Che Wilson, has indicated that if the Māori Party were to make it back into Parliament, they would likely support Labor over National. But is Labor living up to its promises for Māori?
Well, what we're seeing right now, I don't believe so. I mean, we've got a number of Māori seats and certainly an increased number of Māori members of Parliament in this current government, and they're conspicuous by their absence. If it's water, Ihu Matau, if it's whānau ora, Oranga Tamariki, where are they? Why aren't they speaking out? They know the issues.
You are with the Māori Party. Mark, I believe you're not affiliated
not
with any
member of any
directly.
Political party
What's
of this
your
country?
Assessment?
I come from a traditional Labor family. I do not believe that they're delivering. Again, there's lots of rhetoric. You know, we will have this relationship, we will do this, but we are yet to see the proof of their rhetoric.
Will Labor lose a Māori seat?
Potentially.
Where?
Could be anywhere.
Well, I hope they do.
The issues are raising all over the country.
I know you do.
Well, I do hope they do, because then you would get an independent... You would get again an independent voice for Māori in Parliament.
Where would it happen?
Well, who knows? Who knows? And people are talking about, obviously, Tamaki Makaurau. There's some whispering about Wairiki, where I live, and, of course, the other one over in Whanganui area. But it's really a matter of our people have high expectations now.
Would Te Ururoa stand again in Wairiki?
I suspect not. I think he'd probably give us a great sigh of relief after doing all of his years there. Mm. And I think he was very effective as well. But, you know, you've always got to take your people with you. And sometimes if you do not, then, of course, you know what the consequences are. But the landscape is changing. And young Māori are disconnected so often from labour force participation. And they're not healthy, many of them. And so what do we do? Do we just say, oh, well, you know, the government's going to pick up on it? No, the government's not going to pick up on it. You've got to have a voice for Māori with Māori in there, actually advocating the whole time. When you have got mainstream political parties, they will always cater to their core constituency, not to the Māori for the Māori agenda. And and young people are getting impatient, as indeed so they should. They have every right to want to contribute in New Zealand society, but they see themselves getting pushed further and further to the margin. And the people who have a leadership role of speaking out to advocate for them, they're actually stumm, saying nothing.
Merepeka, Raukawa-Tait, Tā Mark Solomon, kia ora kōrua. Thanks for your time.
Kia ora.